Greta Thunberg has become a climate change hero, but some adults are still busy questioning her motive, whether politicians and world leaders should be listening, and if her climate facts are actually backed by real science. You're watching What's Trending. Be sure to like and subscribe for more social media news daily.
This is all wrong. I shouldn't be up here. I should be back in school on the other side of the ocean. Yet, you all come to us young people for hope. How dare you?
A year ago, no one knew the name Greta Thunberg. But what started out as a protest outside her school has now become a full-blown movement. Greta has given a TED Talk, traveled across the ocean on a solar-powered sailboat, led a climate strike, and now her emotional speech at the United Nations has sent shockwaves throughout the world, grabbing the attention of people who believe in the climate crisis and those who don't.
You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words, and yet I'm one of the lucky ones. People are suffering. People are dying. Entire ecosystems are collapsing. We are in the beginning of a mass extinction, and all you can talk about is money and fairy tales of eternal economic growth. How dare you?
Greta has even sparked some conspiracy theories from people who think there's something off about her behavior.
None of that matters because the climate hysteria movement is not about science. If it were about science, it would be led by scientists rather than by politicians and a mentally ill Swedish child who is being exploited by her parents and by the international
left. How dare
you? So what you're seeing here is a political movement and a religious movement, and it's fulfilling religious and political goals of the left, but it isn't doing very much for science.
Greta Thunberg is a 16-year-old Swedish environmental activist who has Asperger's syndrome, which she believes has given her an advantage when speaking about climate change.
I was diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome, OCD, and selective mutism. That basically means I only speak when I think it's necessary. Now was one of those moments.
She's been organizing the next generation who will inherit the earth we give them, or at least what's left of it. And Greta's speech at the UN was directed at the adults who hold the power to either fix it or continue to wreak havoc on the planet. And she did not hold back.
For more than 30 years, the science has been crystal clear. How dare you continue to look away and come here saying that you are doing enough when the politics and solutions needed are still nowhere in sight? You say you hear us and that you understand the urgency. But no matter how sad and angry I am, I do not want to believe that. Because if you really understood the situation and still kept on failing to act, then you would be evil, and that I refuse to believe.
Greta also cited several terrifying facts about climate change, and some are questioning the validity of it.
The popular idea of cutting our emissions in half in 10 years only gives us a 50% chance of staying below 1.5 degrees and the risk of setting off irreversible chain reactions beyond human control.
This information was shared by the IPCC in 2018 in a 700-page report. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, is the United Nations body for assessing the science related to climate change.
And the mandate of the IPCC is to explore all the relevant options. This report seeks to achieve to provide policy-relevant information to the decision-makers, to the policymakers, without being policy prescriptive. So the IPCC has not the mandate to recommend specific renewable energy policies. However, the IPCC has the mandate to inform the policymakers about the options they have technologically, politically, and also socially.
The organization even won a Nobel Peace Prize in 2007, though many didn't understand how climate change had anything to do with war and peace. Geir Lundestad, secretary of the Norwegian Nobel Committee, explained.
We think there are very close connections between climate and war and peace. And we have seen this in concrete action in the Sahel area. I mean, if you study the conflict in Darfur, in Sudan, and in the neighborhood countries, climate has very much to do with this.
And since 2007, the research has gotten more accurate, and the data has become even more alarming. According to the IPCC, human-induced global warming has already caused multiple observed changes in the climate system.
By the end of this century, if emissions keep rising, the average temperature on Earth could go up another 4 to 8 degrees. What I'm saying is the planet's on f***ing fire. There are a lot of things we could do to put it out. Are any of them free? No, of course not. Nothing's free, you idiots. Grow the fuck up. You're not children anymore. I didn't mind explaining photosynthesis to you when you were 12, but you're adults now, and this is an actual crisis.
But there is some good news. Risks to natural and human systems are expected to be lower at 1.5 Celsius than at 2 Celsius of global warming. And this is why there is a significant push to keep our planet under 1.5 Celsius. In 2015, leaders across the globe signed the Paris Agreement, where each country agreed upon the goal of staying under 1.5 Celsius by limiting carbon emissions. But unfortunately, new technologies have shown data that suggests we are using up our carbon budget way faster than expected. There are a few climate models to measure these emissions.
Global models today now take into account most of the major factors known to affect climate over timescales of days to centuries. These include changes in energy from the sun, volcanic eruptions, the effect of different types of clouds and particles in the atmosphere, the influence of forests and fields, water and ice at the Earth's surface, heat exchange between different parts of the climate system, and, of course, how humans affect the environment as well.
And the most recent subset of GCMs now incorporate biogeochemical cycles and are called Earth System Models. Professor Pete Smith from the University of Aberdeen said,
The GCMs were the models that were used maybe in the 80s, but they had a relatively limited sort of representation of how the atmosphere then interacts with the ocean and the land surface. Whereas an Earth System Model tries to incorporate those land interactions and those ocean interactions. So you could regard an Earth System Model as a pimped version of a GCM.
The IPCC used these new ECM models to collect their data, and the conclusion of the report suggests that we have only a few years left at our current rate of emissions before we blow the 1.5 Celsius carbon budget. Skeptics believe that the IPCC is being alarmist.
With me is Professor Richard Toll at Sussex University. Richard, let's begin with what mainstream media says about the whole climate change debate.
I think a lot of that is exaggerated. If you look at the underlying literature, it doesn't paint that apocalyptic a message at all. Climate change is a problem. Climate change is real and really human caused. It is a problem we need to solve. But apocalypse is nowhere near. The impacts have been greatly exaggerated.
So based on all of this information, Greta has been traveling the world attempting to wake people up to these numbers. However, a lot of people are writing her off. Trump, who pulled the United States out of the Paris Agreement, said, "She seems like a very happy young girl looking forward to a bright and wonderful future. So nice to see." Others believe that Greta is being used and exploited by alarmists and the left.
But you are a child. Shut up! What you're actually witnessing is child abuse. Greta is not a climate change expert. She's not, a political activist. She is actually a victim. When all else fails, the left will always resort to using children because nobody cannot listen to children.
And here's what a Fox News guest and host Laura Ingraham had to say.
Anyone else find that chilling?
A time of tribulation has come.
I can't wait for Stephen King's sequel, Children of the Climate.
In February, Greta responded to criticism with a Facebook post saying, "Many people love to spread rumors saying that I have people behind me or that I'm being paid or used to do what I'm doing. But there is no one behind me except for myself. And I do what I do completely for free. And yes, I write my own speeches." Don't you think that a 16-year-old can speak for herself? So what do you think about all these conspiracy theories, and why aren't all these adults listening to her and taking her seriously? Let us know in the comments below, and for more, follow us on Instagram at What's Trending. You can also check us out on Roku, Amazon Fire, and Apple TV. Just search What's Trending.